Hello, I'm Travis Patterson, a senior software engineer here at Grafana Labs. We've heard the frustration from teams who use logs to run their systems, but are getting buried in noise and ever-increasing observability costs. We're proud to introduce our solution to this, Adaptive Logs. Adaptive Logs helps teams optimize costs by intelligently adapting to their observability needs. Adaptive Logs uses advanced algorithms to identify redundant and unnecessary log data, allowing teams to optimize ingestion and save significantly. Teams can easily manage Adaptive Logs recommendations in Grafana Cloud and see the immediate impact, ensuring they only pay for data that's valuable and speeds up troubleshooting. Adaptive Logs intelligently groups and prioritizes log data based on queried and ingested logs, making reduction a simple click away without any kind of manual work required. And so now that we sort of understand the basics of Adaptive Logs and how it changes based on your needs, let's see it in action. I'll guide you through a quick demo to show you how easy it is to manage log spending. You'll be able to find Adaptive Logs under the hamburger menu in the upper left-hand corner under Cost Management, Logs. From here, there's a blue button that takes you to the Adaptive Logs screen. It'll take a moment for your recommendations to load, but afterwards, this is what you'll see. These are the recommendations provided to you about your log data from Adaptive Logs. The first most important thing to see here is the pattern in this column here. Log patterns are basically just all of the bits of logs that don't change, and this is what Adaptive Logs uses to count your ingested logs and your queried logs. We can also see this query to ingest ratio here, which tells you how much of this log pattern you're actually using. And then importantly, we've got our suggested drop rate here. This is sort of the core of the Adaptive Logs recommendation that tells you how many of these logs that you can actually drop. So now that we sort of understand what we're looking at here, let's actually go through dropping some logs. First things first, there can be a lot of recommendations for your logs depending on the size of your system. So Adaptive Logs allows you to see where they're coming from. So if we want to then narrow these down, for example, I want to see only log recommendations that come from Loki, all I have to do is type that up here in the service filter. And this gives me all of the logs for a service. But if I actually only want to look for really specific logs, I can do that too with a fuzzy search here. So if I want to find this log line that's got all these P's in it, it's really quick to do so. So if you know kind of a part of a log line, it's really easy to find and narrow down what you want to apply a recommendation to. Then when we're actually applying recommendations, sort of the core piece to know is this maximum drop rate and this set button. Basically what this is doing is telling Adaptive Logs to apply the recommendations that it's provided you at different levels of aggressiveness. If we set it to 100% and say set, what it's going to do is just accept all of the recommendations as they've been given. But if, for example, you want to be a little less aggressive, you can turn this down. So if we set this to, for example, 50 and click set, then what you'll see here is that anything that Adaptive Logs has recommended at 50% or below as a drop rate, it's going to keep. But for those more aggressive recommendations, it's going to dial those down and cap them at whatever this drop rate is. So let's see, you know, we want to know what the impact of these recommendations are going to be. We can use the preview button, and we see at this 50% aggressiveness, we can save about 160 terabytes. And that's over the last 15 days. But I'm really confident in these recommendations, and so I'm gonna dial these all the way up and click set and see. Okay, great, we can actually save about 260 terabytes, and this is much better. Now we know that there's always some logs that you have to keep, either for sort of compliance or security reasons or anything like that. And Adaptive Logs gives you a couple of ways to do this. The first way is just sort of on a per recommendation basis. We've got this little lock here, and what that will do is pin the drop rate at whatever you set it at here. So for example, we've got some audit logs here. And we need these for various compliance reasons. So you can see I've locked all of these and they're always going to be pinned to zero regardless of whatever future recommendations are. And if you want to sort of exclude logs from being recommended more broadly, Adaptive Logs also supports a label-based filter where you can really broadly define whole sets of logs that you never want to see in Adaptive Logs. Once you've dialed in your recommendations and you've set everything and you're happy with your drop rate, you can then say apply drop rate. It's going to give you a warning to let you know that you are in fact going to be, you know, dropping some data. and we can click this. It'll take a moment to propagate to the backend. And once this has been done, in just a few minutes, Loki is going to start dropping some of your logs based on these, and you'll see your ingest go down. To summarize, with adaptive logs, teams can painlessly reduce log data, optimize ingestion and storage, and save costs while ensuring critical logs are never lost. All with a simple click and no manual effort. New to Grafana Cloud? Try our free forever plan that makes it easy to explore adaptive logs and start saving. Try it out in your cost management hub or sign up for Grafana Cloud today.